20 pounds. This happens to be one of the smallest muskets available, called a caliber, or arquebus. Some folks would refer to it as an arquebus or caliber. A full musket was a weapon of large caliber, usually a heavy weapon, that was designed to take an armored man off of a horse. Now, this weapon had an effective range of about 75 yards at a man-sized target. The beauty of this weapon, with its smooth barrel, our smooth bore, not only can that musketeer fire a single round ball, but he can fire an equal weight of a scatter shot, or what we call buckshot today. And that's going to greatly increase the chance that you hit your target in a heavily forested place like Virginia. Now, the English come to Virginia in 1607, the perceived threat being Spain. Do the Spanish ever attack Jamestown? No, but they come pretty close. 1609 marks a boiling point in relations between the English and the Powhatan, leading to a four-year war beginning in 1610. 1610, all able-bodied men under martial law are all trained as soldiers. They would all be assigned companies. So aside from your job as tradesmen, guard duty would be one of your regular duties to the Virginia Company. We're going to go through the steps of loading and firing, which would take about 20 seconds in the hands of a trained musketeer. We begin that loading process by priming the pan, opening the pan door, taking a priming flask, you're pouring about a quarter teaspoon of powder into the pan, close the pan, cast the weapon about, pour the main charge of powder directly down the muzzle. And on top of that powder, you would see a round ball using a scouring stick. Return the scouring stick and the weapon's ready to fire. Placing the match into the serpentine. And again, what does the serpent breathe? Fire, indeed. Freeze at your piece. Give. Fire. And that concludes our demonstration. Enjoy your visit, folks. Welcome to Virginia.